As Israeli and Hamas negotiators inch closer to a hostage release deal, Yemeni rebel forces threaten to blow a new front in the war wide open. Tonight, astonishing footage of the moment gunmen hijacked a cargo ship with possible Israeli links.
Approaching a cargo ship in the Red Sea. This is the moment Yemen's Houthi rebels stormed the Galaxy Leader, dropping from a helicopter and heavily armed, screaming as they burst through the bridge door. Guns pointed at crew, a hijacking that threatens to open up a new front in the war. The Iran-aligned group, which released the footage, claims the ship is linked to Israel. Israel says it's British-owned and Japanese-operated. The vessel appears at least partly owned by one of Israel's richest men. It's believed it's being held at a Yemen port, along with 25 crew. In northern Gaza, Israel's offensive has reached the Indonesian hospital. Al Jazeera publishing these videos that show it's surrounded by IDF tanks. At least 12 people died in a strike on the facility, according to the Hamas-led health ministry. And safe from Gaza City's Al-Shifa hospital, some of this war's most vulnerable arrive in Egypt. 28 premature babies, first treated near the Rafah crossing, now receiving life-saving care. The status of three other babies isn't known. Hamas has said it's on the brink of reaching a ceasefire agreement with Israel that could include a five-day truce and the release of hostages. US President Joe Biden asked today if a deal was close.
I believe so, but I'm not prepared to talk.
Believe so?
Yes.
At the Israeli embassy in London, emotional pleas from parents of some of the children being held captive in Gaza. Thomas Hand's nine-year-old daughter, Emily, was kidnapped.
She must be saying every day, where's my daddy? Where's my daddy? Why isn't he coming to save me?
It's been 46 days. In London, Edward Godfrey, Nine News.